everyone. This is In-Game Arts. We did another boxing, another breakdown, another demo. This is Ion Fury for the PlayStation 4. Now, this is an import physical copy. Sadly, since the making of this video, this is the only way to get a physical copy is importing it for the PlayStation 4. It's also available on the Nintendo Switch, but sadly, as I said, only available as an import. Now, this is the base vanilla version of the game, so the on-disc version is 1.00, and there was a small size update. This update size was 70 megabytes big, and will take you to version 1.04 since the making of this video. Now, this update did improvements of the aiming in the game, as well as some bug fixes, tweaks, and alterations to the game. Now, to talk about some of these fixes, now, if you do not update your game, I did experience some problems in the game. The biggest one is that there is some frame rate issues in the game. The game will run pretty smoothly at 60 frames per second, very butterly smooth most of the time. But oddly enough, sometimes the game will just drop down in frame rate and then come right back up. Normally nothing could even be happening and just the frame rate would drop and just come back up. It's not like game breaking or anything like that, but it is annoying and noticeable. Yeah, I did play the game with this 70 megabyte update and it does fix this frame rate drop. As well as that, I have played the game, obviously, and I've let the game paused, and I went off to go do something and come back, and I found the game crashed. I actually recreated this, and the game seems to crash every single time you left your game paused for a long period of time. So most might say, why would you leave your game paused for such a long time, but sometimes you might go to the bathroom or might go to do something or a social event might happen. Who knows? Something could happen, a phone call. And if you leave your game paused for a good long period of time, I'd say it seems about like 15 minutes, the game will crash. So bear that in mind. If you're going to leave your game paused, make sure you save it or you could lose all your progress. So just keep that in mind. Now, onto the game, Ion Fury. Iron Fury is a love letter to pretty much the old standard 90s FPS games of like Duke Nukem, Doom, and Blood, and Shadow Warrior, and so forth, of those 90s sprite graphics, FPS, fast-paced, and action-packed kind of game. Now, the game, as I said, it does it very well. It's a love letter to it. So the game is fast, fluid, and smooth. Then lots of secrets, hidden stuff here and there. Lots of variety of weapons, explosions, and all the other stuff. Mute the soundtrack. It's a hit and miss. Some song tracks are pretty good, but some of them are not really noticeable. It's just more like background noise. Not annoying, but could have been better. But the main character is a strong and good character. I really like her, and then I like her actions and how she gives some dialogue when she's playing through the game. She's actually got some character to it, so it's really nice. But if she does annoy you, you can disable her voice if you want a silent protagonist. That's available as an option menu, so that's always nice. I always like variety in my options. The game is, again, very fast and fluid. It's got a good sized world segments in it, so you can explore around and find areas that you could even not even go to and just explore there and just find hidden items and enemies and so forth and more gear. There's lots of secrets and Easter eggs in this game. The game is very well done. For what it's trying to be as a love letter to old 90s-esque FPS games, very well done. Now, I do need to get on the fact that the game also has another playstyle. You can actually play the game in third-person mode. And third-person mode is actually how I prefer to play most of my games. I'm a big fan of over-the-shoulder or third-person. I don't hate first-person shooters, but I prefer to see my character. And the game does have that as a feature, but you can only access this if you switch your button layout to pro mode. Then you hit circle button, then you can play in third-person mode. There's nothing problem with that, but since the game doesn't allow customization of the buttons, I feel that it's weird that you have to switch the game to pro mode to access a feature. I hopefully they'll maybe fix that down the road or allow you to customize the button layout instead of just having two presets. So if you like to see your character as you're running around, switch the controller to pro mode. Now, other than that, the one thing I gotta also get on is that frame rate drop. Since, yes, it gets fixed with the update, but since the game is meant to be a fast-paced game and have frame rate drops, it doesn't bode well for the developer, in my opinion, for their intentions to make a very fast, fluid, 90s-esque game, but yet have massive frame rate drops. They could have done better to make sure of this. They do fix it with the update, but, again, I don't do DLC updates, microtransactions, or redeem codes, so that update does not exist to me. Also, the other thing is a mechanical things. Now, I do appreciate the old style-esque games of it, but I think they could have done something to make a thing a little bit more fast and fluid in terms of making the performance a lot better. In terms of, and I don't, weapon navigation, you have to use your D-pad up and down, so you have to go through a list of guns to find the gun you finally really want to equip. So this can be cumbersome, especially in midst of action. What they could have done is make sure you have a weapon wheel, so you can like immediately select the weapon through holding down your triangle button or something like that and selecting your weapon you want. So again, it's not the retro, but I think the point is to have retro is to have it modernized, where it's more fast and fluid and smooth for the player. As well as that the game has an emphasization of explosions, so if you explode somebody with a grenade launcher or a grenade or so forth, they'll drop a bunch of armor shards. This is cool, it gives a little variety, encourages you to use your explosives and so forth in the game. I love that. But since you have to manually switch over to like the grenades and so forth, you find yourself less and less to using it because you'd rather just blow them with the gun that you already have equipped than trying to navigate all the menus of the guns to get to the grenade. What you could have done is probably have the circle button or something like that to immediately switches to the grenade, and then you can just hit that button again and switch over back to your main primary gun you had before. Small little things like this that makes the game easy to access and fast and fluid, but yet still have that retro feel. There's nothing wrong with modernizing games to be what we have come to expect in our games nowadays, and just have the feel and the functions of the original retro style. That's my only gripes about the game, is that they have a great system here, they got great game, great enemies, and so forth, though I do feel like they could have had a little bit more variety in terms of the enemy design, but overall they're still really good, very threatening, I love the way they're designed, and just the perspective of the game. But just certain little things like that could have been done to improve the experience in terms of mechanical. And overall, I think the game is really good to add to your shelf if you're a fan of these retro 90s Doom clones, as I like to call them. That they're fun, they're just a great game, and I hopefully maybe down the road they'll get more updates and improvements to the game. Sadly, that means it won't be on a disc, so hopefully down the road we'll maybe get like a complete edition and so forth that has a lot of these bug fixes, like the 70 megabytes update to fix the frame rate issues and so forth, as well as a lot more functionality and customization in terms of controllers, as well as, like I said, a weapon wheel and so forth. A lot more access to for the player. But if you're just straight up a fan of 90s FPS game, this is going to be right up your alley. It is what it's meant to be, as a 90s FPS style. I do love you can play in third person mode, as you can see in the video. I really appreciate that. It's how I play it. Like, prefer to play my games most of the time. So, that's great if somebody who prefers like me, or I know a few people who get motion sickness with first person shooters. So this may help you with your motion sickness of playing this game in third person mode. But again, as I said, it's only accessible if you switch the controller layout to pro mode. So like always, I'll try to leave links down in the description if you're interested in copy. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next unboxing video. Bye-bye!